An electric current I flows along a homogeneous conducting bar with length L, resistivity rho and thermal conductivity K. The two ends of the bar are located at coordinates x is equals to 0 and x is equals to L in the OX axis. The temperature at x is equals to 0 is T1 and at x is equals to L is T2, and T1 is greater than T2, and both the temperatures are kept constant. The heat current Q, that is the amount of heat transferred via perpendicular cross section per unit time flowing in the bar, is described by the Fourier law, that is minus Ks dT by dx. Now we are going to find the temperature distribution T as a function of x. When x varies along the bar at the steady state, assuming no heat loss to the surroundings. Okay. Now let's consider a small differential element of length dx at a distance x, and this is the heat current which is entering in this differential element, and this is the amount of heat current which is leaving. Now these two values will not be equal. Okay. Now the rate of change of heat energy in time at every point x is equals to heat current which is entering minus leaving plus heat generation sources. Now in this case, the heat source will be electric current. Okay. Now we can say that Q at x, or the heat current which is entering, minus heat current leaving Q at x plus dx plus E. Now this E is the electric power, will be equals to dm as dt by dt. Now this derivative of temperature with respect to time will be zero at steady state. Okay, so we can write just Q at x minus Q at x plus dx plus E will be equals to zero. Now these two values will be equal agar yahan par koi source na hota heat ka. Okay, now due to this E, these two values will not be equal. Okay, so on rearranging some terms and dividing both sides by dx, it will become minus dq by dx plus E by dx is equals to 0. And we can substitute this E. We know this E is electric power only. So I square R, and R is equals to rho dx by A, the resistance of this small differential element. Okay. So it will become minus dq by dx plus rho I square S upon rho I square upon S is equals to 0. Now, according to Fourier law, now we can substitute the value of Q from the Fourier law in differential form, that is minus Ks dt by dx. Okay, on substituting this value Q in this, it will become Ks second derivative of temperature with respect to x plus rho I square upon S is equals to 0. Now this is steady state with heat generation. Okay, now steady state without heat generation, in that case this term will be equals to 0, and we'll get d2t by dx2 is equals to 0. Okay, now rho I square upon S plus Ks d2t by dx2 is equals to 0. And on taking this term to RHS, okay, and integrating both sides with respect to x, it will become minus k dt by dx is equals to rho I square x upon s is equal plus c. Now this is constant of integration. Okay, and we'll integrate it again. Now see, jaise ye ks yahan par leke aayenge, so it will become c prime. Okay, so, and then we'll integrate this equation again with respect to x, and it will become t is equals to minus rho I square upon k square into x square by 2 plus c prime x plus c1. Now we are going to find this c1 and c prime. Okay, now this can be derived from the boundary conditions, that is at x is equals to 0, temperature is t1, so it will become c1 will be equals to t1. Okay, because this x will be equals to 0, and at x is equals to L, temperature is equals to t2, so it will become t2 will be equals to c1 plus c prime I, c prime L. Now the c1 is equals to t1 only, and minus this term with x is equals to L. So from here we'll get the value of C prime, that is T2 minus T1 by L plus rho I square L square upon 2K square, and on substituting the value of these constants, this C prime and C1, this equation, we'll get this equation, and this is the equation for the temperature distribution in the bar.